Students, now we do the exercise at page 56 of lesson 7. First question is, take the correct option. Number 1, which of the following is a liquid? Ball, kerosene, table and agarbatti. Ball is solid, kerosene is our answer, kerosene is liquid. Table is also solid and agarbatti produces smoke, which is gas. So answer is kerosene. Number 2, which of the following has a fixed shape, size and volume? Options are stone, milk, juice and perfume. So we can say only these, solid is the fixed shape, size and volume because it is a solid, and solid have fixed shape, size and volume, while milk and juice they are liquid, and perfume it is a gas which do not have fixed shape and size. Number 3, a substance that doesn't dissolve in water is? Options are chalk, salt, sugar and ink. Answer is chalk. It is the chalk which do not dissolve in water. After dissolving in water, it settles down at the bottom of the water. While salt and sugar, they can dissolve completely, and ink also can mix with the water. Number 4. Matter changes from one form to another on. Options are heating, melting, freezing and all of these. So matter, they can change their form from one form to another. Suppose we take example of water. If we heat water, water changes to vapors. And if we take out ice from the freezer and we keep it at room temperature, it will get melt and changes into liquid. And if we keep liquid water in the freezer, it will freezes into ice. It means all these processes can change matter from one form to another. So answer is all of these. Number 5. In a water salt solution, water is a, options are solute, solvent, solution and solid. So in water salt solution, water is a liquid and liquids are solvent. Solvent are the substances which dissolve the solid substance or other substances in it. So here salt is solute and water is a solvent. And after mixing solute and solvent, solution is formed. So answer is, here water is a solvent. Number 6. In which state of matter can molecules move freely from one place to another? Options, solid, liquid, gas and solution. So which state of matter in which molecules move freely? They have large space. Answer is gas. In the gases, molecules are randomly arranged. They can move freely from one place to another. The reason is that when we light a agarbatti in a corner of room, and when we enter the room, we can smell the scent of that agarbatti. So because the smoke produced by agarbatti, the molecules move freely and they spread to the whole room. So answer is gas. Now comes to fill-ups. Number 1, anything that has weight and occupies space is called dash. Student, it is called matter. So matter has weight. Any substance may be solid, liquid and gas. It has weight and it occupies space. So answer is matter. Number 2, a dash has a fixed shape and definite volume. Answer is solid. Solids have fixed shape and definite volume. Suppose we want to keep a chair. So chair will occupy the space and it has a definite shape. So space is called volume. Means it will occupy wherever we will keep it. It will occupy particular volume, definite volume, definite area it will occupy. So also it has fixed shape. The shape will not get changed. Number 3, dash take up the shape of the container into which they are poured. Answer is liquids. These are the liquid. Suppose when we take water in a glass, water will take the shape of glass. When we pour it in a bowl, it will take shape of bowl. And when we pour into the jug, it will take the shape of the jug. So these are the liquids which take the shape of the container in which they are poured. Number 4, a substance that dissolves in a liquid is called solute. The substances which dissolve in a liquid, the solid substances like salt, sugar, when dissolved in water, the salt and sugar are called solute. And the liquid in which it dissolves, if we dissolve them in water, water is called solvent. So solid substances like salt, sugar, they are called solute. Number 5, the change of liquid into solid on cooling is called freezing. If we keep water in the freezer, it will changes into solid, it will change into ice after cooling. So the process is called freezing. So now we comes to true false. Number one, the shape of solids can be changed by applying some force. Answer is true. Students, we can change the shape of solid. Suppose we take a clay and we can change the shape of the clay again and again by applying the force. So answer is true. Liquids flow from lower level to higher level. Answer is false, because liquids flow from higher level to lower level. 3. We can hold gases in our hand. False. Students, we cannot see gas, so we cannot hold the gas in our hand because they move, molecules of gas move freely. Their shape is not fixed. The change, number 4, the change of liquid into solid on cooling is called melting. Answer is false. Why? Because the change of liquid into solid, when liquid changes into solid on cooling, that process is called freezing. So answer is false. Number 5, matter is made up of tiny particles called molecules. Answer is true. Because matter, the smallest particle of the matter is molecule, and from the molecule all the matter are formed, whether they are solid, liquid or gas. Number 6, chalk and sand are soluble substances. False. Answer is false, because they do not dissolve in water, they are insoluble. So an answer is false. Now next question is, unscramble the letters to get the names of different matter. First, unscramble letter RHICA. So R, word will form chair, C-H-A-I-R, chair, solid, the state of matter. Next is G-I-V-N-R-A-E, the word, the matter will form vinegar, vinegar is sirka, V-I-N-E-G-A-R, liquid vinegar, to which we use for medical purposes also, and when we add onion in this, the onion will get ripened. In the pickles also we add vinegar, it is sour in taste. Number 3, RAI, the word will be, the matter will be AIR, air. Number 4, AYCL, the matter will be clay, CLAY. Number 5, KOSME, the matter formed will be smoke, SMOKE. Number 6, GRASU, the matter will be sugar, SUGAR, which is a solid matter, solid substance. So with this, I end up my video. Have a good day, students.